So you can order these directly from the electrical connection from their website, or you can get them from Sling Mods or Slingshot only, maybe some other distributors. I think Pimp My Slingshot has them, but this is the isolator. So this is what comes in the isolator kit. Okay. Then I recommend getting the 5-to-4 converter. That's this kit. This is everything you will see in it. Upside down. And of course, the last thing is the isolator sub harness kit. This is plug and play. It connects right into your tail lamps. Lewis is the electrical connection. He's done an amazing job of putting all this package together. All right, so one thing we didn't show you in the install video is how to remove the battery box cover. So you got two of the plastic push pins, one here, so we're gonna pop the pin out, then we're gonna pull out the plastic connector. There's two T40 Torx screws, one here, we remove those. And now the trick is getting this thing out of here. So I'm gonna pull it back, I'm gonna flex it down until that pops out. Now we're connected here, don't break this tab off. Okay, if I recall, pull down and then slides right out. So that's what that connector looks like. Don't break it. Again, that goes in. You tuck everything in to put it in. It's not as easy as it looks by yourself. And then it pops up. Okay, to lock in place. So I won't show you that again. Here's your battery box. This is a little bit different than what we've seen on the other Slingshots. I'm glad Polaris changed it. They've got a fuse block holder inside, your negative cable, then your positives up there. We're gonna go ahead and disconnect the battery before we do any electrical work. So we're gonna disconnect this and away we go. So here we are on the first step of the instructions. Actually, it says number 2. Let's locate the connector for the tail lights. We're going to install one of the sub harnesses. So here's a tail light. There's a sub harness they're talking about connecting in. So we're going to put one of these on each side. I'll go ahead and hook it up and show you what it looks like. So you can see we've installed one sub harness. I'm going to flip over to the other side. Eric's going to install the other one. Go ahead, Eric.
This clip here, there's a little catch underneath. You just push it up and slide it off. And then this new one that comes with the kit plugs right into the existing. And you'll hear it click.
And plug the other end in. There you go. Easy peasy, plug and play. I'm gonna reconnect the battery and we're gonna check the lights because I've said there could be some issues with those harnesses. So we're just gonna check them really quick. Here, go ahead. Okay, we got lights, we got left turn, we got stereo, we got right turn, we got brakes. Got brakes, so all looks good. Good music. Well, let's look at number 3. Using 2 wire ties, make one longer. Secure the isolator shown on the left. Mount the canvas module by peeling off the backing on the tape and mount as shown. Well, you need to go get your own double stick backing tape. I got this product from 3M, weather resistant. That's what I'm going to use. So let's kind of help you out with these instructions a little bit. I'll take you over to the Slingshot and show you what they're talking about. Okay, now we're on step 3. We're going to put some double stick tape, some mounting tape on the back of the canvas module and the isolator. As you can see, I put it on the canvas module.
And now I'm gonna put it on the isolator. I lost my help, so bear with me while I try to do this with finger dexterity. Well, that's pretty good, Rich. Okay, so we got that done. Now we're gonna stick them in place. Oh, and if you didn't know how to make two zip ties into one long one, you just connect them together like that. Voila, and now we've got a longer one. So we're working on the driver's side of the vehicle. Just so you know, the instructions are a little bit hard to see. But when you look at this picture, that's the orientation we have, okay? So Eric's gonna grab the canvas module. He's gonna stick that in place. He's gonna make sure he has enough wire to hook to that ground for the where the taillight's connected. So he's got that on there. We've already run the double zip ties in. He's gonna stick it to the frame with the double stick tape. And then when we run the zip tie, he's gonna make sure it doesn't clamp on any wires. So he's gonna go underneath the wires and tie that in place, so we don't bind that green wire at all. So again, the electronics are far more sophisticated in these things than I am. I won't even try to understand what's in those modules, diodes and capacitors and who knows what. So we're not hooking up any wires right now, but he's got that one tight. And then right next to it is gonna be the isolator. So you can see we've put the 3M industrial double stick tape on. There's no right or wrong. You can put it on either way. It doesn't really matter, but he's gonna stick that into the frame.
I think I wanna go this way, don't I?
Yeah, that way's fine, just like that. Under that bracket, we'll get a picture of that, if you can see it. So side by side, right next to each other, now he's gonna stick the zip tie in. And again, you don't wanna bind any wires when you do this, but you wanna secure that module as if the tape won't hold it itself. And like I said, at Wycked Hitch, we don't sell these. Our insurance won't cover it, but we sure as heck don't mind installing them for people. But as you can see, you can do it yourself quite easily. So here's a warning. Got to properly ground the canvas module as stated. Make sure your battery's disconnected. So here's what they're talking about. Here's the canvas module ground wire. There's the canvas module. Here's the ground wire. We got to ground that to this lug. And you want to check, make sure that thing is well crimped. And I may crimp it again. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and put that together. I lost my filming help, but coming from the isolator, it says you've got two white wires. So I took the rubber band off. I've stretched that isolator out. It says take the longer of the two. Here's the longer of the two. That's the wire. This is the wire we're gonna shorten, put a connector on, and we're gonna ground it with the canvas module right there. Step four in the instructions. Again, you can see that the shorter white, the same length as the other wires, that goes to your trailer wiring harness. A long one, you see here, I'm gonna cut. So you can see I've shortened that wire and stripped it. If you don't know how to do that, I'm sure there's video, you can use a knife or whatever. And part of that kit that came with it, there's a nut, two washers, and the connector. So I'm gonna go ahead and stick that on and crimp it. Here's my attempt at filming a crimp, but I use a blue crimp spot on my crimper. You can see I frayed the wires out, just hold it in place. I crimped it good, and now we're gonna put it together. So the instructions say a flat washer, ground the canvas module, ground the isolator, another flat washer.
Jeez.
Hard to do by myself. Another flat washer, and then the lock nut. That'll stay on there. You try to film by yourself and get all that done right. Okay, so we're gonna tighten that down, and it's gonna look just like the picture on the instructions. Any kid that bought an erector set can put this wiring harness in. So not to get confused, next thing we're gonna do is connect the 5-to-4 wire converter for standard trailer harnesses. Okay, so the biggest thing is to make sure you have it grounded, and we're gonna stick that black ground into the ground coming out of the isolator. And of course, we've already ground the isolator. And so Eric's just connecting those. He's gonna make sure he gets a good connection. The crimps are good. And so that ground, everything, remember, is grounded to there. So now we're good. So now he's gonna take the sub harnesses. He's got that one locked. Okay, and then you're gonna take the other little harness that came with the adapter, and he's gonna plug that into that one. And sometimes you just gotta force it a little bit. Flex that down. There he goes. And you just wanna make sure, you know, all these connectors are clear so you can actually look and check the crimps on them. That was one of the complaints with some of the earlier harnesses, but I think that problem's been resolved. So now we're just gonna connect wires and get everything ready to go. Okay, this is where things can get a little confusing, so we'll take you through it step by step. So remember, we put in the converter, but that doesn't change anything really. It just adds an extension and converts the harness. Okay. So here we go. Connect the wires as follows. Green from the canvas module to wire number 5 on the left taillight sub harness. So there's a green from the canvas, and Eric's finding the wire labeled number 5. Remember, we're on the driver's side, and there goes my phone. He's gonna go ahead and connect those together. Good evening, this is Rich at Wycked Hitch. Hey, Jimmy. Again, here's a canvas module right there, and this is a white wire with the blue stripe. We're going to hook that to number 6 on the left taillight sub harness. Just getting those insulators to work. You want to make sure you get a good connection, and you can see how he's sliding that insulator around there. We'll probably put tape around them. So again, here's where we are in the instructions. We just connected the green from the canvas to number 5 on the tail sublight harness, and the white with the blue stripe to number 6 on the left taillight. We're still on the driver's side. Now we're going to work on the wires for the 4-pin plug. Okay, so here we go. So that's the adapter we put in. So we're going to take the blue from the 4-pin connector, that's that one, and we're going to plug it in to the blue from the canvas module. You've only got 2 wires left. So there's a canvas, he's gonna plug that one in. And he's checking those connections. Now he's gonna take the green from the 4-pin connector to the green from the canvas module, and there's also a red connected to the green. So see those 2 red and green coming from the canvas, gonna connect to the green. Now he's going to take the brown from the 4-pin connector to wire number 3 on the left tail light. So he's got the brown. He's looking for wire number 3. There's a maze of wires, but and there's 3, and that's going to the brown. Is there 2 wires going in that brown or not? No, just brown. Okay, he's going to take the yellow from the 4-pin to the yellow extension wire that's included. So there's that yellow extension wire. He's going to go ahead and hook that on. He's just making sure he gets that insulation around there also. Okay, so that's done. Now he's going to grab the insulation jacket. He's going to connect it to wire number 3. And he's going to slide the supplied split loom over the yellow wire and use the supplied wire ties to secure the wire to the frame. So we'll get that ready. We'll start it. But we'll show you how we do that. I'm sure you guys can figure it out on your own. So here's wire number 3. Now we're on the passenger side. That sub harness. And Eric's going to hook that wire in there. We're going to tie it off. Make sure nothing rubs. Okay, the yellow's connected. We ran it through the hitch. Got a zip tie there. Ran on over there. We may put another zip tie in to hold it in place. So you'll notice we have a white wire. If you read the instructions, this can actually be used to power any accessory. You might want to add a fuse to it, but you'd use the blue wire, the 5th wire. That would be that one. And those two hooked to a switch can power rear lights or LEDs, whatever you want to do. So that's in the instructions on how to hook that up. We're just going to leave them loose for now. Okay, we're going to skip hooking up the red wire to the battery, and we're going to move to hooking up the wiring harness that goes to the trailer. Remember, so we're on step 9, and if you look at step 8, you know it says do not connect wire color to wire color. There is no standard in the motorcycle community. I think we're pretty good here. So we've got the 5-to-4 converter. So we're going to hook the white to ground. Yeah, and we're going to do it with wire nuts first before we solder everything. So that's a white wire coming out of the isolator, coming out of the isolator. So that's that wire coming out of there.
On this one, they're labeled, which is ground, taillight, left and right turn. You might not have one that's labeled, so you'll have to check the paperwork that comes with it to figure out which one goes to which.
So the last one we did, this is a Hopkins connector. We bought that at O'Reilly's Auto. So again, just to check our wiring, we're going to use our wire nuts. Okay, that was the white to ground. The green goes to the taillights. And if you look on the Hopkins connector, which one says taillights?
Brown.
Brown. So green goes to taillights. So remember, do not connect color to color. It's confusing, but it works. Okay. So green went to the taillight, so blue is not used. That's for brakes, but that's what can power your accessories now. The brown goes to the left turn and the brake. So the brown from the isolator goes to the left turn and brake. Again, these instructions are right on key. Do not connect color to color. You will only confuse yourself. Okay? And the last thing, the yellow goes to the right turn and brake. Remember, we're doing the 5-to-4 converter. So yellow goes to the right turn and the brake. Use the wire nuts so we can check our connections. So now we'll get set up and we'll connect the power and then we'll run a test. Okay, so we took the fuse holder, we crimped a butt connector on one end. We should probably solder that. We crimped a round connector to go to the positive on the battery on the other end. We took the fuse out. Eric's got the red wire from the isolator. Got the iron on. Now he's gonna slide it down. I'll come to the other side. Slide it down into the battery box area. So you won't be able to see this. I'll go down. And we're trying to get it down here. And there she is. Okay, so now we're gonna splice in the fuse holder and then get that connected to the positive on the battery, if you can see it there somewhere. You tighten up that battery, make sure your wrench doesn't hit the negative and short it out like it did to me. Actually, just a few sparks. Okay, everything's connected. There is no fuse in there yet. So we got the Sylvan Sport hooked up. Those are quite a trailer, by the way. I highly recommend them. And when we hook up the wiring harness, we're gonna do it with the vehicle off. I've blown that fuse, hooking it up with the slingshot running. So Eric's gonna go ahead and hook it up. I'll let him get in and start it up. If we did everything correctly, everything should light up. I see trailer lights. Left turn. Right turn. Brakes. Yep. Hazards. Yep. Start it up now. We got running lights. Everything works. Love it when a plan comes together. Hit the brakes one more. Yep, good to go. LED to LED though. So as you can see, we actually soldered all the connections together. We put heat shrink on. So we're gonna go ahead and slide the heat shrink over. Down, we'll actually tape that also, give a little extra layer of insulation. But we'll do that on each wire. Get ready to button things. Okay, we've got everything wrapped up, ready to put the cover back on. So we've isolated all the hot wires, or isolated. Put the split loom on. Ground's good. See, we've got the split loom on the trailer harness. That's where we soldered things. Got a little fat right there, but we didn't want anything to rub raw. Got these two wires, remember, coming from the harness. You had this white wire. I extended it because I'm going to use it to power an accessory later. I'm going to run it up front. And then we have the blue one, which was the brake. It's hot. We can put a fuse on there. So we're going to run these two to a switch to power accessories. Okay, so actually I'm going to run this one for you. Let me see where I'm going to run. I'm going to run it down underneath, over the gas tank. If I can get it. There she comes. And we're going to run down. It's going to connect. There's a little slot we cut in the plastic, and that's going to hook right there. And when not in use, we put the cover on it, we slide it in the receiver, you won't even know it's there. Forgot to show you where that converter went, so we just tied it right there with a zip tie and some double stick tape.
tied everything else off. That's our final installation. Or that's the hot wire that goes down to the battery from the isolator. So isolator, canvas module, and 5 to 4 wire converter. And the yellow jumper wire goes all the way across to the right taillight. So that's your right turn signal wire and right stop lamp. Everything just runs down and to the receiver. Okay, so we're going to clean that up. And that's how I install electrical connection, trailer wiring harness for the Polaris Slingshot. Let's haul our toys, boys. I just buy a wiring harness extensions and just run those through my different hitch sets setups. This is our high capacity hitch. Then over on the bench, you can see our, that's all set up. You can run a 4-3 foot extension through that. And then that purple one behind it's a gooseneck adapter we did for a customer named Dan in Oregon. Everything's wired internally.